How to analyze the power on of Android device, a step-by-step guide. The power on cycle of a mobile device is the process by which the device is powered on and the operating system application is launched. The boot cycle starts when the user presses the power button and ends when the device is ready to use. During the power on cycle, the phone goes through a series of steps to check components and prepare the system for booting. These steps include checking memory, authentication cycles, searching for any available software updates, loading services, and applying the operating system. Once all the steps are completed, the device is ready to use. One of the major issues faced by those who are performing repairs on mobile devices is the lack of knowledge about the power on cycle and its consumption. In this regard, it's important to know how the boot cycle works in order to perform a good repair in your workshop. This involves knowing the fixed consumption associated with the devices, as well as the steps necessary to turn it on so that the equipment can remain working correctly. By knowing these details, the users will be able to perform a repair efficiently and professionally. The boot cycle is a series of steps that are performed to turn on a device. These steps vary depending on the device and its usage, but generally consist of booting, configuration, functional test, security checks, and shutdown. The energy consumption depends on the number of the connected circuits and the usage they have, but there are several types of consumption: fixed consumption, high consumption, oscillatory consumption, start-up consumption, standby consumption. The truth is there are too many consumption. There is why I record this course to answer to your doubts. According to my experience, of the 100% of repairs coming into a normal street shop, 70% are easy repairs such as screen changes, battery replacement, charging connectors, microphones, SIM card readers, and some broken connectors. 20% of the devices need a medium-high level of repair, and between 5 and 10% need a high level. In this course, we'll focus on the 20-25% of repairs that need a medium-high level of knowledges. If you understand the boot cycle, you can be able to repair between 90 and 95% of devices. Mobile phone repair can be a complicated process and requires a complete analysis. In most of the cases, detecting a short circuit is relatively easy since the excess current is heating up an area or a capacitor or diode is short circuit. The problem becomes complicated when the current is very low, as it can be as low as 10 or 20 milliamperes. For this type of fault, it's necessary to perform a good theoretical and practical analysis. For this reason, having a thermal camera in your laboratory becomes an indispensable element for the correct repair of the devices. There are also other techniques such as rosin technique that is within everyone's reach. Remember that we all have started without having a thermal camera, and then little by little we have invested money in good tools. In our laboratory, we are prepared to tackle any doubts related to the analysis of water damaged devices, devices with strong blows, or completely dead devices. Thanks to 9 years of accumulated experiences, we are offering this course so that all the participants can take advantage of the information received. To repair a shut down device, each of us employs several techniques.